Woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Happily Ever After. My name is Edward Akameza. I'll be leading the ceremony today. And before we get started, there are a few key people I'd like to recognize. First, the bride's mother and father, Roy and Shelley, right here. The groom's mother, Dina. The groom's father, Ron and Vista. The groom's father and groom's and his fiance, Vista. And then obviously the proprietor of this awesome place, Ron and Georgia. I'm sorry, Gordon and Georgia. Thanks so much for letting us have your have this wedding here. You guys can be seated. Again, guys, welcome to the fairy tale wedding of Seth and Kierstin. Spend any time with Seth and Kierstin, and you are compelled to root for them. You want to be on their team. You're inspired by them, and you're more than willing to throw your support behind them. Seth and Kierstin, do me a favor, take a look around you. Take some time, look at all the faces. All your friends and your family, these are people who love you, who supported you, and who will be there for you. We all love you so much, and we're all super, super proud of you. Today's perfect. You've been working, Seth has been working with Uncle Gordon for 6 months to get this place perfect, and it looks amazing. Wouldn't you agree? Yeah. Kierstin, you look beautiful. You look like you just stepped out of a magazine.
In the scripture of Matthew 7, Jesus tells us a story about two people who built their houses. One built a house on the rock, one built a house in the sand. And Jesus talks about he who built his house on the rock is the one who listens to him and puts his words into action. And then a storm came. Big major storm, and both houses got beat up on. Both houses, both men who built the houses, endured the same storm. But the difference was that at the end of the storm, the house that was built on the rock was still standing, versus the house that was built in the sand crashed down. and everything that was invested in that house, all the dreams and the hopes that were put into the building of that house, all the people that lived in that house had to suffer. But you two are building your house on the rock. And again, I believe in you. I fully expect that though seasons of challenge will come, because they happen to both houses, they happen to all of us, you guys will remain standing because of the way you built your relationship, because of your uncompromising and unwavering and unashamed belief in Jesus and in his word. For you guys, it's more than just a good feeling. Obviously, Kierstin is 100% beautiful and 100% smart as well. She's one of those people you look at and you think, wow, how did she get everything? It's not fair. And then Seth is a man's man. He's like a real-life Captain America. And even though everything points to you guys succeeding, the fact that you met in ninth grade, the fact that you've fought over the past 9 years to keep your marriage, to keep your relationship, and to please each other, the fact that your mother last night told me at the rehearsal dinner that there was a time of testing in your relationship, and you told her, "But Mom, nobody respects me like Seth does." That's not something you hear all the time. All those things point to us wanting to root for you and for us being on your side and supporting you. But even with all those things, that's not why I have such confidence here. Like I said, your unwavering and unapologetic belief in Jesus and his word is what I know will keep you standing through times of testing. The Bible describes a relationship that Jesus has with the church like that being of a groom with his bride. And in the same way that Jesus didn't hold anything back from the church, he didn't hold anything back from us, we as husbands and wives shouldn't hold anything back from each other. The sacrifice on the cross is the defining act of love displayed to us. The cross is what elevates Christianity from a religion or just a set of ideals into a relationship. Seth and Kierstin recognize that, and they want to take a moment right now to recognize that everything that they have and all they hope to have in the future comes from that sacrifice on the cross. As they drink the wine and eat the bread, they consider the blood spilled and the body broken in order as a means to what they have today. Seth and Kierstin have chosen both traditional vows and personal vows. So at this point, ladies, get your tissues ready. Guys, this is the time you're gonna have to hold back some tears if you, because this is it. It's coming. Kierstin is your wife. To live with her in holy marriage, you promise to love and to comfort her, to honor her, and to keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Repeat after me. In the name of God, I, Seth, take you.
In the name of God, I, Seth, take you.
Kierstin to be my wife.
Kierstin to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse, for richer or poorer.
For better or worse, or richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health. Go ahead.
Sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Kierstin, do you take Seth as your husband to live with him in holy marriage? Do you promise to love him, to comfort him, to honor, to keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Repeat after me. In the name of God, I, Kierstin, take you, Seth, to be my husband.
In the name of God, I, Kierstin, take you, Seth, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow. Right.
Who has the keys? Or the rings? the keys to the rings. All right. Put that on. Go for it. Strong hands. That's beautiful. So guys, by the powers vested in me by the state of California and by God himself, I can now pronounce you husband and wife. Seth, let me kiss your bride. Yeah, you are married. But these still are important.
Yeah.
All right. So Seth, why don't you go ahead and go first.
Kierstin, a.k.a. Pussycat. I thank God, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, for blessing me to have the love of the most amazing, beautiful woman I've ever known. But I can't describe how deep my love is for you. It continues to grow daily. And not only are you the foxiest thing I've ever seen, you have a breathtaking hind. But what I really love about you is how you constantly lay down your life for others. You're always serving. You are a picture of selflessness. You make me feel like the most loved, respected, and successful man on earth. And I love how you look at me and how you tell me you're proud of me and that you respect me. And how you say that you love me so much, you would do anything for me. You are my best friend, and you have my heart. I promise to love only you, and to make you feel loved every day, even on bad days. And I promise to protect you, and to lay down my life for you, to make sacrifices and compromises. And I promise to never leave you. I promise to establish our family as one who serves the Lord.
Seth, I love you because you are the most positive and selfless person that I know. You are always willing to help anyone. I love you because you make me laugh, and I always have the best time with you. I love you because you don't judge me for giving road rage. I love you because you are comforting, supportive, and kind. I love you because you make me feel so incredibly loved and beautiful. I promise to laugh at your jokes, even when I've heard them over and over. I will honor you and trust you. I will be loving through good times and bad. I promise to be your partner through life and to love you unconditionally.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So now, I can introduce you for the first time anywhere, Mr. and Mrs. Seth Parrish.
Pleasure to introduce the bridal party, bridesmaid Ariel and Nicole, accompanied by groomsman Lane. Bridesmaid Tajali and Jen, accompanied by groomsman Adam. Bridesmaid Shelley, accompanied by groomsman Mike. And the maid of honor, Ashley, accompanied by the best man, John. Ladies and gentlemen, up out of your seats. Everyone, please stand and give a very warm welcome to the new Mr. and Mrs. Seth and Kierstin Parrish. Oh, let them have it.
I got those backwards.
Enjoying this day with Kierstin and I, and right now we're going to have our pastor Edward bless the food. So here is Edward.
All right.
Hopefully I don't forget anything this time. All right, let's pray. God, thank you so much for today. Thank you so much. You've worked everything out to be such a perfect and beautiful day. We're so grateful, Father, for Seth and Kierstin. We're so grateful to be here and be a part of their love, God, and be a part of their marriage. God, I pray you bless the food. I pray you bless everything that's talked about it in every conversation at all the tables. God, I pray everything that we do here today brings glory to you. We love you and praise you in Jesus' name.
take some.
Yeah. And but before I say anything about the two of them, I just want to look around here and I see so much support for these two. And so I just really want to thank everybody for coming. And I know we've gone around and we thanked everybody, but I think that it really deserves a lot of acknowledgement because you guys have done, there's so much effort here. And I know that people have traveled a long ways. There's been people needing to take time off work and babysitters, and there's just so much. But I know that, you know, they're such a special couple that that's just all, you know, with it for everybody. So thank you. And then I also, I'm not sure where they are, but I want to give another thanks to Kirsten's Uncle Gordon and Aunt Georgia. We've already talked about how there's been a lot of effort that's gone into this place. I think that what some people don't know is that Kirsten, from a long time ago, has wanted to get married on Uncle Gordon's property. And so...
Well, I had to buy this place.
That's so true. That's so true. So he moved in at the end of last year. I think they've been in here. I think they were in here for maybe 3 weeks. And Kirsten and Seth announced their engagement. And these two were still in boxes. And not only were they announced that they were getting married, but that also it was going to be in 6 months. And there was absolutely no hesitation on either of their parts. It was just excitement. And everybody just kind of rolled up their sleeves and got to work. And the planning began. And these two had a vision. And it all came together. And it was not without a lot of sweat and a lot of, you know, these two traveled and, you know, weekend after weekend and worked on this place, I want to say tirelessly, but at the end, I saw it, Seth was getting tired, but he was driven. And, but then we also had so much, all the bridesmaids, all the, you know, the whole bridal party, they were all recruited and they did so willingly. We had family members and everybody just came together at the end. It was up until an hour before the rehearsal dinner last night. And what a blessing. Everybody just, you know, just pulled it together. So I know that, you know, it was all meant to be. And God really put everybody in play to make this all come together for the two of them. So thank you again, Gordon and Georgia. We love you guys. And thank you for all your support with that. And so, okay, now I get to say something about our beautiful bride and handsome groom. Yeah. So, let's see, where do I start? There's so much that I could say about the two of them because, as we know, they've been together for almost 10 years now, and they're just so, as young as they are. Kirsten was, dare I say, at the tail end of her 13th year. Age 13, which, by the way, didn't always go over real good in our household back then. But that love prevails, obviously. Yeah. I wasn't going to name any names, but you know, he wants to be acknowledged. So. But these two, I know that everybody knows what an amazing couple they are. I am so proud of them both. I've been so blessed to see, obviously, not only my daughter, you know, grow and just grow into such a beautiful individual, but also Seth, and together also as a couple. The love and the support and the commitment that these two demonstrate is now and has been very apparent for all these years. And I've seen them, the strength in their relationship is always there. Something that happened, though, that I think was kind of a pivotal point in their relationship was when they got baptized together about 3 years ago, I think. And at that point, they really opened themselves up to God and allowed the love of God to really channel through them in their relationship. and it has really transpired into not just a relationship of strength, but just a really, it's a solid relationship. And that was probably one of the most beautiful moments to be able to witness the two of them. And go, you know, you do that. And so at that point, it was really a moment that I think everybody who saw that, we all kind of agreed. I know that some of the other parents, Seth's mom and dad, you know, also agreed too. So, and as well as Roy, but let's see, I was going to say something else. Anyways, but yes, I'm very, very proud of the two of them. And, oh, Seth also, you know, he's just such an honorable young man. And he came to us 6 months ago to ask for Kirsten's hand in marriage. And there's obviously, there's many things I could say about that, but one thing that was really significant was at the end of the night, Roy had made a comment, and that was that if something would have happened that it turned out that he wasn't the one for Kirsten, that he would have been disappointed. And that was something that I have felt for a long time. In fact, Kirsten and I have even talked about that. But I don't think he and I ever did. And so it was just a really beautiful moment. And something, like I said, that I felt, but also that Seth is a son of my heart. And after that moment, what I think is a truer statement is that Seth is really a son of our hearts. And he knows he's loved. And he has been welcomed and accepted in this family long before tonight. But tonight we are thrilled that that's official. So, and I'm just going to close by saying that Kirsten has had a extremely good head on her shoulder. So here's my 2 second brag period. And she has continued to make decisions and choices that has brought her so much success and so much happiness in her life. And so what I want to say to her tonight is that the choice that you have made in who you've chosen to be your life partner is without a doubt your very best decision so far. And I know that it's going to bring the two of you, both of you, just success and happiness and joy, and just continue to deepen your love and your relationship. So here's to Kirsten and Seth, and woo! I love you both so much.
Cheers.
And I think Ron, Seth's dad, Ron, is going to come up and say a few words.
You missed it.
I know you guys don't have enough.
I was about to drink your champagne.
Yeah. Thank you.
We'll get him right.
I'm Ron Parrish, Seth's dad, Kirsten's new father-in-law. Thank you. With an applause like that, I don't think I need to say any more. Thank you. Well, there's a lot of people that put a lot of effort into this, and it's obvious. And I appreciate that. And I also wanted to thank Pastor Edward and his wife, Brooke, coming all the way up from LA and doing such a beautiful job and making it fun. Thank you. Also, we welcome the Gray family. We welcome you as one now. We're all family. And I want to thank my family, my father, for instilling values and ethics in me, which is obvious that Kirsten's family did the same for her, and the love that I got from my mother. She's the most loving person I know. The support I get from my fiance, my children, they've loved me. You know, this is all part of what we have here. The final product is the love and the value and the ethics that have been instilled in them as they grew up. It's obvious. You two are meant to be together. I believe that. Kirsten, we greet you into our family with open arms. We welcome you. We're a bit dysfunctional at times, but we share a lot of love, okay? I just want to say a few things about true love. True love is the acceptance of all that is, all that was, all that will be, and all that won't be. The happiest people in life don't necessarily have the best of everything. They just make the best of everything they have. I heard a story a while back about true love, and it's a short story. I want to share it with you. It touched me so much that I thought it would be appropriate right now to share. It went like this. There was an elderly man in his 80s who went to the doctor to get some stitches removed from his thumb. And the nurse noticed he was in a hurry and asked if he had another doctor's appointment. He said that he needed to get to the nursing home to have breakfast with his wife by 9. So she asked about her health, and he said that she had become a victim of Alzheimer's and hadn't recognized him in over 5 years. So the nurse said, "And you still go have breakfast with her every morning, even though she doesn't know who you are?" He says, "She doesn't no longer recognizes me, but I still know who she is." And that is true love. And I believe that's the kind of love that you two share. Thank you. All right, let's give it up for the best man. How's everyone doing tonight? Good? All right. Well, for those of you who don't know me, I'm John Slane. I've been friends with Seth for a long time now. I'm going to tell a little story about how we all first met Seth. There's a lot of us here that have probably the same story. But, you know, we all played football together for a while, and Seth was from Forest Hill, so a lot of us didn't see him because we all went to middle school together. And we were all out, you know, practicing, hanging out in the field, and we see this guy come out. And Edward put it great, you know, Seth, Captain America, comes walking out, you know, just everything. And, you know, at first, I wasn't a fan of Seth. I thought he was a little cocky and just doing his own thing. But eventually, we grew together, and, you know, as any sixth grader would, I asked Seth if he wanted to come scooter with me. You know, so we went and rode around, rode some scooters, became really good friends, and that carried on all the way through high school. And one of the reasons why I consider Seth one of my really good friends are he went to college, and I went and did my own thing, and I was separate from everyone else, but Seth always kept good contact with me. He would write me, talk to me all the time, and, you know, it really gave me a good connection with back home, so it was a great experience for me, and I consider Seth a really good friend. And for those of you that don't know, we went on a backpacking trip. It's almost been a year, last summer, almost, and it was really good. We got to know each other really well. We spent a lot of time in the woods. It was like 19 days. That sounded a little weird, me saying that. But trust me, it was. But long story short, Seth, we were out there, and we were chilling around a campfire, and he mentioned to me, you know, we were just talking about life and girls and different things, and he mentioned to me that he was going to propose to Kierstin, and he had already had a ring, and, you know, I was eating food, and it honestly didn't faze me much, because I figured they had been married for so long. It's been, you know, ever since I've known them, they've been married, in my opinion, so. But they're both great people. I can't, you know, they've done so much for me. Kierstin is amazing. At times, has been a great friend to me all the time, and has been a mother figure sometimes. You know, we've had a little bit of mischief and a little things go wrong, but we've all had good times together. Everyone's sitting in here, and you guys are really fortunate. If you just look around, there's a great group of people here. Everyone cares about you a lot, and I just say we all have fun. Let's cheers! Cheers to Seth and Kierstin for having a good time.
John, that was nice.
Hi, I know you're totally over speeches now, and excuse the piece of paper written in front of me, but I need to look down at it, otherwise I'm going to start falling.
Relax.
Okay. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Kirsten's older and only sister, so I'm obviously the best. I've had the honor of growing up beside her. She's the most loving, selfless, and kindless girl, now beautiful bride. in many ways, I've admired and looked up to her, and in many more ways, I treasure her more than anything in this world. We've shared just about everything together, and the memories are countless and priceless. One of the memories I'd like to share with you is Kierstin and Seth's first date. I remember like it was yesterday. It was their freshman year of high school, and we came home from school and doing our daily things, and she came up to me when mom and dad weren't in the room. And she goes, "Ashley, oh my God, the hottest guy in my class asked me out." I'm like, "Oh my God." And of course, the best part, he is a football player. I mean, can it get any better than that? No, but little did we know at that time that it actually would get better. So I remember getting her ready for the date and mom and I dropping her off and Kierstin going, there he is, oh my God. And mom and her are like, oh, he's so cute, I know, right? Like, and ever since then, he has been in her life and our life. Birthdays, prom, graduation, summers, holidays, everything. He has been right there with her and with us. And so yes, it does get better. It's 100 times better because he asked for her hand in marriage. So you didn't just date him, you married him. So that is a total fairy tale story in itself.
Yeah, baby.
I know I'm supposed to say welcome to the family now, Seth, but just like my mom said, you have been a part of this family for so long, so I can officially say that I have a brother. I'm so excited. So I just want to say, I can't look at you, but thank you so much for being my sister's best friend. And for always having her side, always treating her like a lady should be treated. I've never, ever had to worry about her heart, as an older sister would, being very protective. I never once had to worry because her heart always belonged to you and vice versa. So I'm so incredibly happy for you two. Okay, now I really have to look at the end. Okay, so here's to Kierstin and Seth. As you continue to conquer this life together as one of the best teams I've ever seen, may you keep your faith strong and keep growing spiritually, and that you look each other in a million different ways and love each other in each. I love you both.
Thanks, babe.
Yeah. Thanks for the bartenders. They're amazing. Let's go dance.
Everything was just a bore. All the things I did, things I've done.
look. Look at your face. You're driving good.
Nicely done.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on the dance floor as husband and wife, give a very big round of applause to the new Mr. and Mrs. Seth and Kierstin. Hey.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you. And the way you look tonight, yes, you're lovely with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight. With each word your tenderness grows, tearing my fear apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose, touches my foolish heart. Lovely, never, never change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you.
Congratulations, you two. Ladies and gentlemen, this next dance is set aside for the bride and the man that walked her down the aisle today. We'll be right back.
And just watching her, it breaks his heart, cause he already knows.
This would be a great time to please escort your mother and join you on the dance floor.
Yeah. Go, Mama!
From sleepless nights and rocking chairs, your smiling face was always there. From little trucks and building blocks, you held my hand while I lived. You were my best friend, my inspiration, one I looked up to. Hey Mom, the first lady in my life was you.
Parish is
There were bedtime snacks and nursery rhymes. Good night prayers, there was always time. You taught me to live by the golden rule. Made sure I got to Sunday school. You disciplined with love my whole life through. A gentle touch was all I ever knew.
Everybody join the bridal party. Come on, everybody on the dance floor. That's right.
Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. We show up, we gon' show up.
places with the ladies. Come on, guys. All the single men to the dance floor. Come on, guys. There you go. You wanted some man music. Come on, guys, give him some encouragement.
Give him some encouragement.
Get it. Have it. Yeah. Yeah. Right there. Oh. Oh. Yeah.
Look at him. John told me. Stop it.
Oh, push him down on it. Come on. He's got it.
Love me tender, love me sweet. Never let me go. You have made
strong hands.